So hi guys, so today we're going to learn about introduction to computer programming. Okay, so basic thing we have to know before learning this thing is why we have to study computer programming. So today we are seeing a lot of apps like Swiggy, Ola, Uber, anything. What is the one main or what is the common thing in all of these things? We all know, yeah, they are giving a lot of offers, but that is not the thing. For example, if you don't have a car, okay, and if you want to reach airport in a luxury car, we can be able to afford that luxury car in a less price compared to the guys who are offering it outside. So, and Swiggy or Zomato or whatever it may be. If you want to have food in home, again with discounts, 50% discounts, we no need for us to go out from home. Okay, we can just be able to sit in our home and we can order our things pretty easily. Okay, so all this is possible only with what the computer programming. So this is a very interesting and one of the most advanced technology and which is very easy to learn also. So this session will give you a foundation on how to write a program, how to think. For all the problems, if we can just think, we get the solution. So I will be teaching you about flowcharts and other basic things which are required for being an efficient computer programmer. Flow chart. From the name itself we know, flow chart. Chart means what? Pictorial or pictorial representation, which means with diagrams. Which means what? With diagrams we will use this thing. Flow chart means what? With respect to diagrams. So diagrams will help us to easily recapture these things. Okay. And diagrams we know, nothing much we are going to do. We are just going to draw a circle, maybe a line, maybe a rhombus shape. Okay, and I'll be telling you what is the function of each and everything. So flow chart or any diagrammatic representation will give us an easy flow of visualization which help us to write the coding. Example to demonstrate some of the flow charts. For example, if the condition is true, for example, we are having two choices, either to walk and go to the vegetable market or take our bike and go to the vegetable market. So we are again thinking, am I tired? If it is true, then I'll take the bike. If I'm not tired, then I'll take the walking thing. So just think from the lowest level, okay, while writing the programming, then you will start loving it. It's actually very easy and well below the level. It is not as hard as we think. It's very, very easy and anyone can write a program. Only we should have only up to 8th standard skills or maybe 5th standard also. A, B, C, D we should know, that's all. And we should know how to add two numbers. Sum of two numbers is what? 1 plus 2? 3. If we can do these things, then programming is not that big. It's very, very easy. Only thing is that we have to give some time and patience for this. Pseudo code. Okay, the pseudo code for this. Pseudo code for the programming. Pseudo code is nothing but, previously in flowchart what we learned through diagrams, in pseudocode we will be writing those in words. So again, programming can be divided into four quadrants: numbers, words, variables and diagrams. Diagrams is our flowchart where numbers, variables and words will come into pseudocode respectively. So here the average grade of the class, average grade of the entire class. So what we will do for this? We should know the average formula, which already we know from our 8th standard or 9th standard, how to calculate the basic average. Sum of the marks, okay, sum of the marks were total number of subjects. Sum of the marks were total number of subject. So what is the average here? Sum, for example, let's take the average mark is 80% in a class. So what will you do? We'll add every student's thing and divide by the total number of students or the number of subjects in this thing. So such an easy thing, and we can get the average marks. And why, what is here? Display average is given. Display average, in sense, in computer if you write the program, there is something called output, okay, so which will display. So that is called our displaying thing. So here we won't use any programming terms. Here again we are using a simple English term, and you should be able to what, think and write these kind of codes. Pseudocode is not the actual code, but the way to calculate these codes. This is just an example. So don't focus too much on this. This is the flowchart representation, start and end or stop. Okay, and what is this rhombus shape? Okay, we are just thinking, like the previous example, whether I have to walk or go to the bike. So we are just thinking. And what is this parallelogram thing? To take the action, to take the action. And what is this increment counter? What is this rectangle box? Statements. Again, these are all statements. So very well below the line, very basic things which anyone can write a good program. Now let's see the program thing, C program. Okay, preprocessor directives, hash include, these are called library function. Library function, which means already predefined within the program, already we no need to tell them what. See, for any machine to operate, they need what? Instruction. For us to operate, we can think and do, but for machines, we need what? Instructions. Int main. Main means main function of the program. Without this, no program can't be written. Int main. Int means integer. It's a data type. What is data type? We all know that our memory card is nothing but what? Let's say 256 GB of memory card. Or else 128 GB. Some may have 64 GB. Some may have 32 GB. So, integer means how much memory this main function is going to take. Okay, normally in program we'll get void main. Void means nothing, null. Okay, null. And here declaration statements, executable statements, return zero. Declaration statement in the sense, what we are trying to do with this. And for example, class marks is there. We are going to declare that, okay, class marks are there. Executable statement, okay, average of the total class. Why return 0? If it is void main, we don't need a return 0. But if it is integer main, we need return 0 because integer has a value. And I don't want to waste my memory space. That's the reason I am giving 0 here. Example program. Hash include stdio.h. What is this library function? And these are called comments. If you don't write this thing also, no problem. This is all not required at all. Okay. So, int main. Printf, welcome to Sanjeev Academy. Printing the thing. Output, welcome to the Sanjeev Academy thing. Now coming to this type of data type. Okay. So we all know that without a database or a memory card, nothing will work. And again, these memory cards are divided into two things, rows and columns, like a table. Just like this table, it is divided. So character, if I am typing some words, I am doing how much bytes it is taking? One. Suppose integer. Okay, so each and everything, okay, they occupy space in our memory card. For integer it is 2 bytes. For real number, float means 4 byte, double. So mainly we use char, int and float. Double we don't use in any programming. Okay, for characters you write character, integer you write integer, float for decimals. For example, if I want to have 2.568, if I chuma give integer, it'll come only 2. If I include decimal values, I will use float. That's the only difference in this. Key terms, token. We all go to a bank, okay, and we get what? Token. For example, if you want to deposit some cash or something, now there is a deposit ATM deposit machine, but I'm talking about 5 years back. If you want a deposit machine or you want a withdraw machine, first thing we will go to a bank and we will get what? Token. This is before ATM, not now. Okay. Token is the name, they give a small coin. So here also in computer, token means what? The smallest individual unit in a program. Smallest individual unit in a program. That is called a token. Okay. Which is the smallest one. Okay, that is called a token. Keywords, we just now saw what? Integer, float. Okay, so these occupy all what? Memory spaces. Keywords are nothing but, without the keywords, the computer won't be able to understand the thing. Identifier is both for us and for the computer. For example, in C programming, if you are giving printf, which means printing or displaying, scanf for entering the value. And constants, we all know. For example, we are writing like int a is equal to 2. Integer is what? Data type, keyword. A is a variable, 2 is nothing but a number. So that is a constant. Operator. Yes, we will use lot of operator like plus, minus, division, okay, multiplication, everything. That is something about operators. Simple program. Write a program to calculate the area of a triangle. Hash include std dot h. Don't forget this thing. This is there in each and every program. If you don't want to write return 0 here, you just chumma write void main. Then you can exclude this line. And how to calculate the area of triangle? Area of triangle is what? Half into length into breadth. So this is the logic which should be there in your memory. This is the thing which should be there in your memory. Or half into base into height, whichever. So the picture of a triangle should be there for you. Half into base value should be there and height value. So if you know this thing, we can calculate the area of a triangle. If you know this thing, we can write any program. Area is equal to what? Half into length into breadth. And what we are doing? Printf, identifier, for us to identify. Enter length and breadth of the triangle. Scanf. Enter the length and breadth respectively. And 4 and 5 we are giving half into 4 into 5. This is nothing but our output. So answer is 10. 2 into 5, 10. So examination again, we have to write like this. Without writing like this, they won't give any mark. So just come back to your lower class level. Even if the questions are based on matrix or anything, just go to the 12th standard book or something. Just see what is matrix and how, what is matrix, rows and column. So we can do any program based on this. We can do any program based on this whole thing. Okay. So that's it for today's session, and I hope you understood each and everything in this. For any doubts or thing, just put a comment on the video.